My life has been a tapestry of rich and royal hue, an everlasting vision of the ever-changing view, a wondrous woven magic in bits of blue and gold, a tapestry to feel and see, impossible to hold. Once amid the soft silver sadness in the sky, there came a man of fortune, a drifter passing by. He wore a torn and tattered cloth around his leathered hide, and a coat of many colors, yellow, green on either side. He moved with some uncertainty, as if he didn't know just what he was there for, where he ought to go. Once he reached for something golden hanging from a tree, and his hand came down empty. Soon within my tapestry along the rutted road, he sat down on a river rock and turned into a toad. It seemed that he had fallen into someone's wicked spell, and I wept to see him suffer, though I didn't know him well. As I watched in sorrow, there suddenly appeared a figure gray and ghostly beneath the flowing beard. In times of deepest darkness, I've seen him dressed in black. Now my tapestry's unraveling. He's come to take me back. He's come to take me back.
his office that they found somewhere. He came to my office. And then together, the two of us, longhand, mostly Rudy, worked out the proposals for courses, which would then have to be typed up with examples of lesson plans, topics, course outlines.
Can you imagine?
And bibliography for each of about 8 courses, which we figured would be necessary.
Yeah.
And then Rudy presented these to the campus curriculum committee, which is God Almighty. They alone can approve the creation of a new course.
Right. Those and are so all the courses I took.
The Black Studies Department proposal.